Hello friends, the topic of this video lecture is oxidative phosphorylation. Different cells in our body have different jobs. To perform various functions, every cell needs energy, which is derived from burning of fuel, that is glucose, in our body. This conversion of glucose into energy takes place in each cell using their own cellular machinery, and so the process is called cellular respiration. The earlier steps of cellular respiration are glycolysis and Krebs cycle. Glycolysis takes place in the cytoplasm and the product is pyruvate molecule. This pyruvate molecule then enters into the mitochondria with the cell's own energy expenses and acetyl coenzyme A is produced. Acetyl coenzyme A then enters into another cycle called citric acid cycle, also called Krebs cycle. Glycolysis and citric acid cycle produce some reduced coenzyme A, NADH and ATP directly. However, much more ATP is released on oxidation of these coenzyme NADH and FADH2 when they enter into the process oxidative phosphorylation. Oxidative phosphorylation is the terminal process of cellular respiration and it's a vital part of metabolism taking place on the inner membrane of mitochondria, and it accounts for very high ATP yield. Oxidative phosphorylation is a set of coupled reactions, and the first reaction is electron transport chain. It's an hexagonic process, means it releases energy when the electrons are transferred across this chain. So this is the electron transport chain present on the inner membrane of mitochondria. This is outer membrane of mitochondria. Here is the intermembrane space and this is matrix. So the transfer of electrons from electron donor like NADH and FADH2 released in this reaction from succinate to fumarate in the Krebs cycle to the final acceptor, electron acceptor, which is oxygen, takes place. However, the cell does not release this energy all at once, as this would be an uncontrollable reaction. Because too much of energy is produced, which neither can be utilized at once nor can be immediately stored. Instead, the electrons are removed from NADH and are passed to oxygen through a series of enzymes or protein complexes, such that at each step, there is a release of small amount of energy which can be then stored or utilized. The second step, the second reaction here is movement of protons across the intermitochondrial membrane. So with, as you can see, the transfer of electrons taking place simultaneously, there's a movement of protons takes place across the inner mitochondrial membrane from matrix to the intermembrane space. And the energy released in the previous step is actually utilized here to move these protons, to drive these protons across the membrane. And with this movement, a proton gradient is built. That means higher concentration of protons in the intermembrane space and lower concentration of protons in the matrix, as well as a difference in the electrical potential is built. That means more positive charge in the intermembrane space and negative side is the matrix side. Together, the potential gradient and the electrical potential is called as proton motive force. The third reaction in the oxidative phosphorylation is chemiosmosis, means the protons move again to matrix down the proton gradient. So, because the higher concentration of proton is on the intermembrane side and the lower concentration of protons is in the matrix, protons now move again back to the matrix down the proton gradient, but they use a channel which is present in the fifth complex in inner mitochondrial membrane called ATP synthase. So, as these protons move down the gradient into the matrix, they fuel up this complex called ATP synthase. So ATP synthase is made up of two parts, F0 and F1 particle. It is also called oxisome or F0 F1 particle. ATP synthase F0 particle is like a mechanical motor which is embedded in the membrane, and when the protons move from higher to lower concentration, the stored potential energy gradient that fuels up the F0 motor, which causes the central stark to move, which leads to the final reaction of oxidative phosphorylation, that is ATP synthesis. This diagram will explain you better. As the protons from higher concentration, which is in the inner intermembrane space, try to move through the channel present in the ATP synthase back to the matrix, the stored potential energy fuels up the F0 embedded motor, which causes the movement of this central stark. This is how it happens. These white colored balls are the protons present in the inner intermembrane space. As they move through the channel present inside the ATP synthase, it causes the movement of F1 central stark, which is hanging in the matrix. As the F1 particle moves, it exposes the active site for the substrate. And the substrate here are ADP and phosphate molecule. So as the F1 particle moves, it exposes the active site, to which ADP, again it will happen. As it moves, it exposes the active site, ADP and phosphate molecule attaches, which releases then ATP, and hence the synthesis takes place. So this is the process again. F0 particle moves, causes the exposure of ATP, active site, ADP and phosphate molecule attaches again, and then ATP is, this is how it is released. So this is how it takes place. Now, the set of enzymes in the electron transport chain consists of complex 1, 2, 3 and 4. These are present in the inner mitochondrial membrane. These electron transport molecules consist of water-soluble cytochrome C, lipid-soluble coenzyme Q, some protein-bound iron sulfur clusters and prosthetic group, which is FMN and FAD. So they together cause the transfer of electrons to the final acceptor, which is oxygen. So let's discuss these complexes in details. Complex 1, which is also called NADH coenzyme Q oxidoreductase. Why is it called so? Because in the first complex, NADH is oxidized and it releases 2 electrons, and coenzyme Q accepts, so it is reduced. So that's why oxidoreductase. We can see here better. NADH molecule, it oxidizes to release 2 electrons, which are accepted by coenzyme Q via FMN group and iron sulfur cluster. As the electrons pass through this complex, 4 protons are pumped from the matrix into the intermembrane space. So this is complex 1. Complex 2 is succinate coenzyme Q reductase. Again, as the name symbolizes, succinate, it's the second entry point in electron transport chain, where the succinate is oxidized to fumarate, releasing electrons in complex 2, and via FAD and iron sulfur cluster, it is the electrons are accepted by coenzyme Q, which is also called ubiquinone, which is then reduced, and hence the name is succinate coenzyme Q reductase. But as this reaction releases less energy than the oxidation of NADH, so this complex 2 does not transport any protons across the membrane, and so it does not contribute to the proton gradient. Complex 3 is also called cytochrome BC1 reductase, because it consists of cytochrome B and C1. Reductase, because these are accepting the electrons, so that's why reductase. It is also called Q cytochrome C oxidoreductase, because here coenzyme Q is being oxidized by releasing the electron, and cytochrome C is reduced because it is accepting the electron. So you can see here that coenzyme Q is releasing electrons via B, cytochrome B, iron sulfur cluster, cytochrome C1, and finally the electrons are accepted by cytochrome C, which is then reduced, and hence is the name cytochrome C reductase. Here also there is pumping of 4 protons across the inner mitochondrial membrane. And the fourth and the last complex is cytochrome C oxidase, because here cytochrome C is oxidized because it releases the electrons to the final acceptor of the electron transport chain, which is oxygen. So this enzyme transfers electrons finally to oxygen, which is reduced to water, consuming the matrix protons and also pumping two of the protons across the membrane. So this is also contributing in the development of proton gradient across the membrane. So this is how these four complexes help in the transfer of electrons. And so oxidative phosphorylation is coupled with two reactions, and that is electron transport chain and followed by synthesis of ATP by the fifth complex called ATP synthase.